everybody. Welcome to Meet and Make. My name is Zoe Allen and I'm a freelance artist with Baltic. And today we are going to be creating and curating. Did you know that while we've been in lockdown, there have still been exhibitions on at Baltic which no one can get inside to have a look at? And if you, like me, have been really missing visiting our galleries and seeing artworks, here's something you could try to get you through the last little bit of lockdown. You can become a curator. If you look at Baltic's website here, that's baltic.art, you will see that there is information about the different exhibitions, like this one, which is called Against Time with works by Huma Baba, or this one, which is called The Making of Husbands. If you click through on that link, you'll find exhibition tours, so you can see those exhibitions virtually. You'll be able to see the gallery from all different angles and kind of explore through it like this. It's amazing. So today, your task is to create your very own gallery and curate your own exhibition. And if you want, you could design your very own tour, just like the ones on the Baltic website. It's not as tricky as it sounds. Here are some of the things you will need to start with. So to make your gallery, we're just going to use a cardboard box or even just a sheet of strong card. Some paint, if you have some. I'm using white paint for my walls, but you can use whatever colour you like. You might need some scissors and some glue and some tape. So first, we're going to make a rough gallery space. We can change it later or add more bits in or add more walls if we want to later on, but this is just to get a good idea of the scale that we're going to be working at. Galleries come in all different shapes and sizes, so it's completely up to you how yours looks. I'm going to make mine using a nice big cardboard box like this one, but if you don't have a whole cardboard box or you just want to make one wall of a gallery, that's absolutely fine too. In the virtual tours of Baltic, you can see that some of the galleries are made up of two or more spaces all joined together. So you can join more spaces onto your gallery if you want to as well. Or if you want to, you can add those later if you find that you need more space. The first thing I'm going to do is to give my gallery a nice big door so that people can go in and out. But I'm not going to give my gallery any windows. Sunlight can sometimes be damaging to artworks, and I want to be able to control the light in my gallery space. Also, windows take up loads of wall space, and I want as much space as possible for my artworks. Now, because this is a model, and I'm pretty sure that I'm going to be putting works on the walls and on the floor, I'm not going to put a ceiling on my gallery at the moment. But if you think that you might want to hang things from the ceiling or use the ceiling in some way, then you can put one on there, or you could always add one later on. So once I've cut out my door and got my walls the right shape, I'm going to just neaten up the edges of those with a little bit of tape. And I'm also going to kind of build in a title wall, which I'm going to put in front of my door, so that I can put the title of my exhibition on it and so people will know what it's called. But it also means if people are inside the exhibition and looking out of the door, there's nothing there interrupting their kind of vision and their view of the exhibition inside. Once I've got all of that structure and I'm happy with it, I'm going to paint my gallery. Now, I've created my gallery space. I'm going to paint it white because I think, for me, that's going to be the best colour to show off the artworks I want to put inside. But you can paint your gallery any colour you like, and you can always change it later if you find you don't like it. So exhibitions come in lots of different colours, and it depends on the artwork that's going to go in them. So look at this gorgeous brightly coloured exhibition wall from the Judy Chicago exhibition, which was at Baltic in 2019 and 2020. So when I've got my exhibition paint, my gallery space painted, I'm not happy. I want more space in there. And fortunately, one of the good things about making models is that you can change the shapes and sizes really easily. So I'm just going to add a little extra bit on here. Awesome, that's better, and I'm going to paint that bit too. And then I'm going to think about what I actually want to go in my exhibition. I've got lots of wall space for artworks that are wall-based, but I think that I might want to put in some 3D work as well, and so I might need something for that to go on. Now, sometimes a small 3D work or sculpture is displayed on a shelf or a plinth. A plinth is a bit like a box for the sculpture to sit on. And plinths can be all shapes and sizes because sculptures are all shapes and sizes. So I've got a few different kind of tiny little boxes, and I'm going to use these to make plinths out of. And I'm just going to paint them the same colour as the rest of my gallery so that the artwork stands out from the plinth and the plinth doesn't get in the way of you're looking at the artwork. Look at these works in the exhibition by B. Wirtz, which was at Baltic. They're all sitting on a low plinth together. If an artwork is really big, it can go on the floor. And this is a really beautiful floor-based work by the artist Anselm Kiefer, which was on display at Baltic in 2010. So now, my gallery space is looking like this. Now, while your paint is drying, it's time for you to get your curator's hat on. You've done your creating, and now we're going to do some curating. For this bit, you're going to need some artworks. Now, you can make your own artworks, if you want to go in your gallery, or you can collect and cut out images that you like from magazines or newspapers, or if you have access to a printer, you could print images from the internet, but you'll have to kind of have a search and find the things that you like and that you like in your gallery. Blue tack will also be your friend for this bit, but if you don't have any, don't panic. You can use masking tape or sellotape kind of gently to start putting works on the walls of your gallery. If you're not sure who or what a curator is, they are the people who make exhibitions and displays of objects and artworks. But this can be done in lots of different ways, and curators need help from lots of different people to make sure that the artworks that you come to look at are all in the right places. Exhibitions can tell us a story about things that have happened or about a particular artist, or they can ask a question and show artworks or objects which make us think about things in different ways or help us to explore different ideas or opinions that other people have had. Look at this exhibition by artist Daniel Buren at Baltic in 2014. The artworks are made of colour and light and mirrors. So, as well as finding the artworks that they want to display, a curator needs to find out loads and loads of information about the things that they want to show in the gallery. And they can do this by talking to artists or other people who know about the subject, by reading books or articles, by speaking with researchers and collecting together images and information, any other way that you can think to get information that's useful. But then you end up with loads of information, so a curator needs to find the bits that are the most useful in telling the story or answering the question that the exhibition is addressing. Curators have to work with artists and makers and with all the other teams of people in the gallery to make sure that the artworks are on display safely and to make sure that there's enough of the right kind of information about the artworks so that people who come to visit can find out about them. And sometimes curators also have to work with curators from other galleries too. So, the next thing I'm going to think about is what I want to exhibit. I've started with an idea about exploring colours. I've chosen two colours that are opposite each other on the colour wheel, blue and orange. I want to use my exhibition to think about whether different colours and the things that they make us think of can change the way that we are feeling. I've cut out from magazines loads of different things that are blue and that are orange, and now I'm going to think about how I can display them inside my art gallery. They might not look quite right the first time I try this, so I've put blue tack on the back so I can see what they look like in different places before I make a final decision. So if you don't have any blue tack, don't worry, you can gently roll up some sellotape or masking tape and stick that on the back and stick the works onto the exhibition surface using that. If you do it really gently, you should be able to pull them back off again if you're not happy. So I'm also playing with my plinths and thinking about where they might look best and the sculptures that go on them, and thinking about also how much room people might have to move around my exhibition space. I don't want to pack it so full that there's no room for anybody to come and see it. You can see that I've changed my mind lots of times. I've even changed my mind about the colour of my wall, and I've added some blue wallpaper for some of my artworks to sit on top of. When I'm pretty happy with the way that my exhibition is looking inside, I'm also going to think about making the entrance look more exciting. I've surrounded my doorway with blue wallpaper and I've made my title board orange so that visitors to my exhibition can see the contrast in those colours straight away and get a sense of what my exhibition is about. Just to make sure, I've also given my exhibition a title. I've called it Blorange, which is a mixture of blue and orange, and that should make it very clear what my exhibition is about, but I'm pretty sure that you can come up with a better title for your exhibition. What do you think? Now, if you also, when you've made an amazing exhibition and an amazing gallery, you want to make an amazing tour of your exhibition, you could try doing this with a phone or a camera that has a video function and just gently pan your device around your exhibition and make some recordings and see how they look. And if you want to talk over the top as well so that you can give people information, then that's perfect. Now that I'm happy with my exhibition, I'm going to attempt to make a tour too. So I'm going to use my phone and I'm going to just gently kind of go around my exhibition and see if we can get all of the artworks on a video. If you don't want to make a tour, or you could try taking some pictures of your exhibition instead. You could also try, if you want to do something slightly different, curating other objects from around your house, for example things in your bedroom or kitchen, and think about what objects or pictures things have in common, or why things look interesting together and whether they tell a story. That's all from me for now, but I hope you have loads of fun building your very own galleries and curating exhibitions and displays. And please, please share your creations. I would love to see them. Good luck!